kosana ka nkosi lo boza the champ nje yakona first la a hip hop museum e Gauteng maboneng. I'm here to meet up with the guys and actually go down memory lane, checking out the history of hip hop. Perus land along a shit.
Ngitshelithi hip hop ayiqala ngayisikwala Kamp na iPOC ke ilama chita bomtshela ngayo iPOC yiwe waqala lento lena
ngowe nisho ukuthini ukuthi iPOC ke
Pok Tupok Tupok prophets of this.
Look, I think we can definitely without a doubt give it up to we standard, give it up to POC, because of course they inspired all of us. They really got the movement going. But like, even on a global scale, I mean, these guys are recognized by Abu, Quincy Jones, they've toured.
James Brown, open for refugees.
Abu Tribe Called Quest. Whatever we think is really cool right now that people can do, or people who think they're making waves and making moves, you know? Like, these guys did it. Look, yeah. POC did a song where they featured the Josie Cats, Abu Amu, yourself in the J Section.
Yeah.
And of course, J Section born out of the club because of Upayonic right there, you know?
Well, Upayonic, no. Bionic and
Blaze,
yeah.
DJ Blaze, oh, Bionic.
Yeah, you know, Nabo Pigs is nine.
For Skwatta Kamp to be really accepted, you know, it had to take Abu Amu to lay there, Selvi, Shimani.
Yeah.
You know,
Loco.
Nabo Loco, Nabo Specs. Iba abantu abathi okay, yeah. Lever Neck by Faga, you know. And then after Abu Amu.
Ramesh.
Angthol. So I mean, those are the guys. The whole Motherlode collective. But then
Snares.
once you got into the guys that also made it commercially viable. I mean, like, must remember Pionic after the club, they did Eargasm.
Yeah.
So they put out Abu Mischief and then
Abu Specs.
I think you mentioned something important there, because I think that's what changed for me a perspective as a whole in South African hip hop. Because for me it was just rap, you know. But when I started listening to Motherlode, I don't even think Prophets of the City brought that kind of perspective gimme yet.
But when with every project.
When Motherlode came through for me, that was like the breakthrough of that's when I got like the understanding of a role to play in South African hip hop, to say, these guys are literally, you know, speaking my language, first of all, you know, as we mentioned, Uti Venek and stuff like that. So me becoming Upos at a later stage, I mean, it was from Abo listening to Abo Selvin, Abo Shimani, Abo Shodi Skills, you know?
Abo Amu, the J Section, they really laid the ground for us. Yeah. And then once we came, they were a foundation.
Yeah,
and
but when the whole Zola Amu vibe was going, Rao was already out then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we were already participating in the mix.
I mean, the Red Shirt was even like, you know, a bigger song before Rao Rao.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And like, yeah.
So
we've been playing, coexisting.
Yeah. Like slowly.
But to go large. Yeah. By the time the Ghetto Fabulous, I'm saying that was like.
Oh. Pela besi abom rap apa abom rap. That's why into Zola literally like took the rap thing and made it like more. For people to also see it, so it's not just ours.
And then Skwatta Kamp came, first South African hip hop group to go gold. You know what I'm saying?
When gold was still 25,000.
25,000 records to go gold at the time. By the time we had a gold celebration party, we're on 35,000 units.
We're like, gold is old, 35,000 sold.
That was the name of the party. The, gold is old, 35,000 sold. By the time we had that party, there was some more. So like literally the album
went platinum.
Platinum, you know, over there, that's 50,000. But in today's terms, I guess, I don't know, multi-platinum. From the prophets of the city, we took the torch. Repetitivity was there for us. What happened to Skwatta Kamp wasn't only for hip-hop. It happened across a generation. So because we broke the mold, I think a lot of people then carried that forward. into everything. So whether you had a vision of opening a business, or whether you wanted to do a hip-hop magazine, you know, we saw the uptake of like hip-hop radio shows. The Kwaito generation had started it, you know what I'm saying? And then we took it like a bit further. And like for the people that were with us, so I think like that's why Skwatta Kamp is important, because in our generation, it really said you can be anything you really want to be. And case in point, here's, you know, a group of 7 guys and a young lady, you know.
And I think this album made people believe in that notion even more.
Yeah, good ngayenza this thing.
Good ngayenza
most day. And being relatable, so ngoba so lokhu mamela bo Chuck D or nabo bo Puff Daddy nanani, but now here's like guys actually talking about like young guys talking, you know, your language, ikasi slang,
going through what you're going through.
We're talking about izinto that you see, and it's like, yo, never has it been so relatable, because as much as we all loved Kwaito Sharp, 110%, but I think we could really carry a message and convey it heavily and in detail in our songs. So yeah, I think Skwatta Kamp just carried the spirit of, you know, of change. You know, that's really what it carried, that spirit and courage, you know, the spirit of change, the spirit of courage. That's why Skwatta Kamp is important. That's what it carried, and that's what Skwatta Kamp means to the people. That's why it's like Skwatta Kamp for the people, by the people, for the people. El Naturali. What you got up in your daily brown carpet?
Nabo Ugangi. Ugangi. Umlungu with a voodoo. Vibing like Umkulunguru. I kill you like a Zulu. Warrior.
I remember that.
Because it was Gangi.
I don't remember that.
It was El Naturali, then Gangi, then yeah, the other guy. He used to play drums with called him Nunu, Gangi and Nunu.
Yeah.
And then Amachita then like carried on, and they became different names and so forth. But you know, he also plays us in the hood. Out here, and then.
Benga kodlan go to him pedic tabs na ismishile la pego waza la pele in studio ngi kataranga wasida. Asa tia saba bi kataraso.
Fama. I don't know how to play.
No, I don't know how to play. That nigga was about aesthetic before aesthetic, nigga.
Utabule HP, we found Cheba in the space, right?
Yeah, he's been
there. We found him in the space. He was already with the majors and making moves, but...
But he was more quieter than hip-hop.
Yeah, I'm tall. And then, but I think like now with... He was a good rapper, but the music-wise was definitely more... Kwaito, and him trying to fit in with the Kwaito guys and just doing his you know, his own thing.
Yeah, I mean, also the pressure from a crowded crew coming from Mabato, then, you know.
Marabisho, then label, Bebate, Mandoza, now about Mandoza, whatever they... But after Skwatta Kamp, then he too was validated, even with his record label, but no, Mancheba.
Started doing his thing.
Let's go again.
Yeah.
You know, Leila, now let's give you more budget, because now we've been brewing this thing, but like, maybe he's been telling them, guys, let's do it like this.
Tire,
and then, but I, chaba, lento yako America is pani yenze kanje.
And I mean, obviously, one of his biggest collaborator from an instrumental perspective was Tasman. You know,
Tasman. Yeah, Tasman was shayile la mahits na.
Nabo Dukes.
Mutswako came in strong, did they think, Jabba did this
Jabba
thing.
Jabba literally opened the door and pioneered the idea of Mutswako hip-hop. You know, although Mutswako and the Botswana community always existed in one way or the other.
But for me, that whole generation of... Crowded crew
with KB, you know.
I mean, don't
style
it. After Skwatta Kamp, then the whole wave started. H2O, I mean, like, you know, then you had the WHP, the Pro Kids.
Opened up,
and it was that whole era whereby we were, and then Jabba opened up Mafeking. I mean, Pro was doing his thing. But it was really a great time. And then, I mean, one of the greatest lyricists, of course, Pro Lindam Kize, who, I mean, we were with him from the club days. You know, so I mean, equally seeing him win was, you know, just as dope as seeing ourselves win because we're from the same school, you know.
I remember he sent me like a demo of his stuff. We kind of talked about it, and I was like, no.
It was the 985 mixtape because he had done that song, Soweto. And I was listening to Soweto on the 985 mixtape. I was like, una something.
But there was something else that he sent me, and he even came to Brown Carpet. Yeah, with Leondale, Brown Carpet is where we record, it's the studio.
Before it became Chatel Lab. and then Mkukufang Studios.
Yeah,
Chatel Lab. The place to be. Pro Kid came there. No, AKA once came in Chatel Lab.
Chatel Lab.
Yeah.
So Chatel Lab and then Mkukufang.
And then Check Architects.
Then it became 100.
Oh, yeah. Check Architects.
Then it became a Tlipa.
Then it became a Tlipa.
Yeah, 100.
And then once we left the Tlipa, so CBC Brown Carpet.
Yeah.
But Lalela, you know what's funny though? And if you look here, I just want to go quickly.
Oh,
and you,
no.
I'm not. I just want to say that, you know, like, if you look at Amo, him Fedic Tabs, if you look at Dumi, if you look at, like Ninja, if you look at Jabba, you look at Pro Kid, all of them actually came to the brown carpet. You know what I mean? Because we were the only guys who actually had a studio also as artists, if you think about it at the time.
Everybody came there.
Yeah, everyone
came there.
Almost everybody came there.
But I mean, I remember the Entity days because they were at school with Nish's younger brother. Yeah.
And then when they found out, Uti, actually, he is Nish's brother. They wanted to come to the studio to record. I don't know what.
Okay.
And then Itaimalalo, not Talimpofu, one driver, they came to the studio.
So you met Talimpofu then?
Yeah. Abashiera, he goes downstairs. We're still trying to talk with Namachita, try to figure out what they want to do, whatever. Yeah. And then after Womate TV, after Womate TV, guys, my father says we must leave. I'm sure no one's here. Now we keep on getting what you buy. Computer, that is God now.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. We were even in the NTT video, no sneaker.
Yeah.
Remember their first video, NTT one?
Hey, dude.
Blew it in like
boats and
boats. We were like, what are these young guys?
Why you must tell them no city video? No, it happened. It happened, Skirlek.
Ah, best ever, let's route. You know, best when you're in this.
Like it.
That's dope. And then, of course, from the brown carpet to Questa, who I mean, he worked with us, you know. Out there, see, Katlehong, you know, where his tape came across the table, and I mean, like, yeah, Slick was like, let's do it, you know. Was like, let's sign this guy.
He's a little bro. I remember we used to do gigs with him, you know?
Then he signed the Paraping first album. You know, when he came, do you know, he was just called Quest.
Yeah.
And then
With a Q.
Yeah, with a Q. It was Quest. And then I put the A.
Nigga, did you ask for your A back? Nigga, I want my A.
Hey, yo, Quest.
What about that A money, dog?
Hey, I'm Kumbu, that A, yo, Quest. Quest. Where my A at? Not talking about my E, I'm talking about A. Where my A at? Quest. Where my A at?
Father, don't forget you are Nemesis. You also became Nemza.
You are boss.
You became boss. And now Sneak, you became
Sneaker. Now, Bo Smacks, and you became Smack, God!
No, you're getting Smacks! Chet, like, look, they're still building the museum and stuff, and, like, everybody must come and check it out. But, like, Kespa's a big deal. Really, I think for me, I mean, outside of everything that happened in and around our, call it, era, right? So I'm just saying with Mutuako, Skwatta Kamp, Pro, the Jabbas, like I just want to call that like one sort of thing, like that explosion of hip hop, right? for me, the next big thing that happened was can like we, the, we, was the dope.
Sorry, because it confuses a lot of people. Can we now Sifago, aka in our era somehow?
Nah, not really.
He's from a new era.
He was literally at the end of our era. If we talk about even like
an entity medium, that, like yeah, I mean there was.
No,
like,
I'm just saying as a solo, he literally was at the end of. I say end, because I'm saying if you look at Cooley, if you look at Jabba, and you look at them as part of our generation, that generation of Cooley Jabba was coming to an end, and he literally was. Had a little foot in it. That's why he literally like saw it.
No, but and he came around that time, right?
I think more like when we were doing, when we started, I think like, yes, I think that's the Skwatta Kamp, like as I said, that era. And then there's like more or less the times when we all started doing solos. I think I almost look at that as a different era. You know, like that was something else. And then, like, after that...
Because you already had a breakthrough then, like...
When you look at it properly, all these eras, at some point,
They interlinked.
They all interlinked at some point. Like, when someone became big, before, you know...
Yeah, before it fell over. Even though the museum is in the process, and, like, the beauty about this thing is that, like, you know, it never stopped and started with POC, it never stopped and started with Skwatta. Jabba, it carried on to Keenan, Casper, Cuesta, and it's not stopping and starting there. Now you've got like guys like Ricky also. I mean, this museum probably will be filled with like a Blackie, will probably be filled with the Nasty.
This is where this ends, man. Like, I feel this era is a Quebec, all right? What do you think Casper has done for the game?
Casper's done a lot. So what I'm saying is that these guys, Casper, Cuesta, aka Noriki, they had an amazing...
Philip, Digital. These guys moved the game like to another level.
And I mean,
you
even
know?
KO is part of... Oh, like, yeah.
KO is crazy because KO is like...
It's here.
It's all over. It's also so, that side with Tia
Cass. But KO literally starts here as a solo with AKA. As a solo, you know?
And then I wanna, so that's why. So you can live in two eras.
Yeah.
Depending on now it's Skwatta Kamp taking a new album, maybe.
So I call a foot.
Sneak peek into like the rest of the museum and things to come. Sneak peek, follow us quickly. We just wanna walk you through it. Goody's not done, but he's got this Skwatta Kamp section set up. So,
how are you guys doing?
Speaking of
the devil, and he shall appear.
Speaking of Oz, young dollars. Speaking of Oz, takes a machita, mara.
But I think before anything, I mean, this is a big initiative once again. Dope. You know, big up for just doing this. I mean, just being in the path, I know. We're also going to make enough money to also contribute one day. You know what I mean? This is important for the culture.
I have the money, so we need a tiki box.
That's it, Osmi. This is my bump and camera. Okay, Skwatta Kamp said, thank you, Osmi. Shout out. Sisafuna award here today, Mara, my hip hop awards. Mara, shout out. Yeah, shout out. And it's intimative.
Let me explain.
Intimative.
So,
intimate,
you. So this section here, it's milestones, right? Yeah. So obviously, as you where you guys were before, that was the Wall of Fame. Obviously, we did the induction 2019 for COVID, I think. And obviously, as you might know, the whole museum got destroyed. So everything got rebuilt. So since the rebuild, there's obviously a few sections that getting there bit by bit. So one of the important sections is obviously this one here. It's called milestones. Mm-hmm. So what milestones are, it's looking at the different milestones that propel culture forward. So basically, before that specific thing happened, things were stagnant. But when that thing happened, it you know what I mean? So looking at a POC, looking at a mother load, you know, looking obviously at a Skwatta Kamp, you know, looking at a Motoko guys, you know. So in this section, there'll be all those different sort of milestones. And within obviously that section of the wall, it's where obviously you read a little bit about the story of the crew, and there's a small write up, and then on screen, it's sort of like interviews and videos. And obviously we're gonna have something framed Slicka, we spoke 5 years ago. I even spoke to you, but you tend to forget. We spoke 5 years ago when I was speaking to you about the summer.
The summer?
Didn't you steal them from us?
No. Obviously, the conversation was you know, how do we either replicate it, you know? And also the conversation was, to you guys, what is that thing that it's 80 years from now, 100 years from now, because obviously the space is going to outlive all of us. So when your kids come here, what is that one item, or what are those two items? So obviously in the conversation was that summer was like a, you know.
But now, why won't you be sad?
Never slap a slick and nearly cable, baby static.
Ongenza said, Mano, would one day
never understand.
One day over saying, Vile Puruam, Bazongbon Angela Ule Bond.
Finished.
Abunya Upibang Alpuli food.
That's what you get for stealing our award, you get.
So obviously the idea is probably end of, because obviously this year we're celebrating hip hop 50 years of hip hop. South Africa, it's 40 years of hip hop. So there'll be quite a lot of sort of talks and lectures. So down the line, we'll also give you guys a shout where in the space, you know, we invite people, we have conversations and challenges, and you give advice and, you know, all of those sort of, and these are people that propel culture, right? So this is sort of what when you're done, this wall will represent something framed that is dear important to you guys, whatever that is, whether it's the Vaslapa, you know. I mean, I've got Pro Kids shoe. How's about that?
Wow.
We've got Pro Kids shoe.
It's coming, man.
We've got Mischief's rhyme book from the first album.
Serious? Oh,
wow. You know, we got interesting, you know, and we're trying to get more interesting things, you know. So at the end, it's the ideas, the space will have those sort of also, as much as we're trying to make it very modern, because we've got like holograms here and the touch screens, all these things are going to be happening, but also still have that thing, that this thing belongs to this person and this thing is here, you know?
Yo guys, we can't wait till all of you get to see the museum when it's ready. Whoever needs to put up the money, let's donate to the museum, let's get it complete.
Where do we donate?
You know, e-wallet, baby. E-wallet, you know? So we're looking forward to it. Oz, it's a beautiful place. Sabong above.
Appreciate it. And we thank you guys for your contribution.
Congratulations to hip hop. This is big.
Thank you guys.
This is big.
We thank you guys for your milestone.